He's a many-faceted performer with much to say about movies and more. Stanley Tucci is in conversation with our Holly Williams.
I feel English when I'm walking through here.
Do you really feel English?
And I speak English when I walk through here, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Just the language, not the accent.
We tracked down the very funny, very charming Stanley Tucci in London just before Christmas. Tucci is that actor who you've seen everywhere. Often stealing scenes. Sometimes entire movies.
All right, everyone, gird your loins.
It's earned him a cult following, though Tucci claims he doesn't understand it.
Yeah, people are saying that now. I don't know what that is.
I think it means that you have people who watch a film for you, even if you're not in the starring role.
I guess that people really like the variety of the performances. And that's what I sort of revel in. I love that.
From an ideal husband to Meryl Streep's Julia Child.
You can teach in our kitchen.
True.
You can teach on television.
To a deranged serial killer in The Lovely Bones.
Because I just built this thing over here and I want to get a second opinion. Do you mind taking a look?
A role that won Tucci an Oscar nomination. And now Supernova, in which he and Colin Firth play a middle-aged gay couple.
I told you no matter what happens, I did not want to lose control of my life.
Tucci's character is suffering from early-onset dementia.
I'm losing control.
One of the things that's interesting is that the sexuality of the two main characters is not a theme in the film at all.
No.
It's a universal love story.
Yeah. People are starting to come around and understand that love is just love.
If you had one wish in the world, what would it be?
Well, I wish this holiday wouldn't end.
Tucci helped get the film made, including sending the script to his friend, Colin Firth.
I am on the edge. Now I'm more on the edge.
Having played a number of gay characters, you know, you want to do it so that it's, what you should do with any character, you just want to be truthful to it.
It's been muted, but there has been criticism from some quarters saying that gay roles should be played by gay actors. What do you make of that?
I have difficulty with that. I think that acting is all about not being yourself. If we were to use that as a template, then we would only ever play ourselves. I think what we need to do, we need to give more gay actors opportunities. People who are gay have only recently, in the last few years really, have been able to say, I'm gay and I'm an actor. And I can play straight roles and I can play, but they always had to hide their sexuality so that they could play the leading man or the leading woman.
Tucci was born in a suburb north of New York City to an Italian-American family. He started his career on the stage, but was hungry for roles in film and television. What he didn't want, he told us, were the parts playing violent mafiosos, normally offered to Italian-American actors.
I didn't want to play that person all the time. It's not interesting. There are brilliant movies made about the mafia, but you can't. How often do they come along? Most of them are just sort of cheap rip-offs of the brilliant movies.
In frustration, he says, he co-wrote, co-directed and starred in Big Night, a very different type of story about Italian-Americans.
This is what the customer asks for. Make it. Make the pasta. Make it. Make it. Make the pasta. Come on, let's go!
Two immigrant brothers struggling to survive in the New Jersey restaurant business in the 1950s. The film also starred some of Tucci's family recipes.
What is that?
It's timpano.
The film helped get Tucci noticed and was also just the beginning of his very public obsession with food.
I grew up in a family that put great importance on food, and it was everything. It seemed to be just about the only thing we talked about.
Tucci has authored two cookbooks, has a food memoir on the way, and recently filmed a series on CNN about Italian food in Italy.
Io non posso mangiare più.
Perché?
No, perché è troppo. È delicioso.
Sei sciupato.
How good a cook are you out of 10?
With certain dishes, 11. But no, but with a lot of stuff, I'm okay. I'm an okay cook. Maybe a 5.
At 60, Tucci seems to be savoring his success, but he's also experienced horrendous loss. His wife, Kate, the mother of their 3 children, succumbed to cancer at the age of 47.
You never stop grieving. You never stop grieving. And it's still hard after 11 years. It's still hard. And it will always be hard. But you can't let it. And she would never want any of us to sort of to wallow in that grief and let it take over our lives. She would never want that. She wasn't like that.
In recent years, he's found love again with Felicity Blunt, a British literary agent, who's also the sister of Emily Blunt, Tucci's co-star in The Devil Wears Prada. And his very British wife and their 2 young children is also how this quintessential New Yorker ended up living here in London, where he's enjoying yet another cult moment. He posted an Instagram video of himself mixing a Negroni for his wife during lockdown, which quickly went viral.
You want it, Felicity? That will never happen.
Followed by more cocktails, garnering millions of views.
Why do so many people want to watch you mixing cocktails?
I have no idea.
Do you really have no idea?
No, honestly, I don't. Why do you think? Tell me.
You know, I don't want to be inappropriate, but they are, they're quite sultry, some of these.
Sultry?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, there were always a lot of sexual comments.
How do you feel about that?
I was very flattered. But it was great. I mean, you're incredibly flattered when people are just sort of going gaga over you.